He just take another four and I'll do it.
Turn this motherfucker up, man, so it can fuck with my eardrums a little bit. What's up, badass? Where the homies at? No suckers in the gangster party. What's up, Nate Dogg? Nigga, y'all gotta kick rocks. Yeah, the suckers gotta get out of here, cuz. Yeah, on the smash on these suckers. All pound gangsters only.
Some try to rip me by low. Others never try, cuz they know. I know I told you that the game don't wait. I'm so tight that I can wait for the game. I'm just about as tight can be. That's why you never see you fucking with me. It's your chance to bow out gracefully. You're standing face to face with defeat. If you feel me, say nay.
Nay.
You be the tightest motherfucker in here.
All pound gangsta gang.
Rude. We be the hardest motherfuckers in here.
Some things never change.
We be the hardest motherfuckers in here.
All pound gangsta gang.
We be the hardest motherfuckers in here.
Bring your bitch ass in, close the door. Now you wanna run and fetch me a hoe. Motherfucker, tell your mama tiptoe. When she pass my dough, corrupt. Got this bitch bout to toss this hoe. And when we making nigga shit, always making the killing. I be hearing you bitches, there go the villain. Mad cause your revenue stopped from drug dealing. Mad at me cause I'm making shit them thugs feeling. Hold my dick, nigga, spit that verse.
Well, Nate Diaz says he should have fought Joey Ferguson a long time ago, but tonight on the
Yeah. She walking out already?
Yeah.
It's been a pleasure.
It's been a pleasure.
It's been a pleasure.
It's been
a pleasure.
Water.
saying.
I don't give a fuck, I keep it gangsta, y'all.
This one's for you.
Put your hands up.
Out of Stockton, California.
Put your hands up. Put your hands up.
Out of Stockton, California. Fighting out of the red corner, a Gracie Jiu-Jitsu fighter, holding a professional record, 21 wins, 13 losses. He stands 6 feet tall, weighing in at 171 pounds. Fighting out of Stockton, California, presenting the Ultimate Fighter Season 5 winner.
Tony, now you've been over the wall in the dressing room, you know what I expect. Keep yourself protected, listen to me. If you want to touch, now's your time. God bless you.
Oh, Diaz, check that kick.
Sequence for Diaz at the end of the round. Teammate has now found John Jones with the ninth most significant strikes landed in UFC history.
At 2 minutes, 52 seconds of the fourth round, declaring the winner by submission due to a guillotine choke, Nate Diaz!
I'm here with the winner, Nate Diaz. Ladies and gentlemen, how about a round of applause for a legend? It was a wild fight between two real veterans. What was it like coming into this fight today after all the chaos of this week, particularly yesterday?
Full-blown wrestling fight camp. I didn't do no boxing, so we made that happen.
Was there any concern whatsoever about switching opponents?
No, I'm just here to get my job done. I had one fight left. I told him, give me anybody you got. And at least I got a worthy OG representative of mixed martial arts to do it on. At the end of the day, I love the UFC. Shout out to Dana White. Lorenzo Fertitta and Hunter Campbell for giving the opportunities and the platform the whole time for everybody and for myself. I feel like I'm the most, right now, I feel like I've had the longest career in the UFC and I've had the most successful one at everybody. I outdid everybody on pay. I outdid everybody on surviving.
Nate Diaz, ladies and gentlemen.
Thanks, Joe.
I'm here with another legend, ladies and gentlemen, Tony Ferguson, two legends.
And making a great job and making the adjustments that we needed to make last minute. And, you know, we did what we did. So it was awesome. And he was able to incorporate a lot of the stuff that we worked on today.
Awesome. So did you envision the fight going down the way you did?
Pretty much, yeah. I mean, he did great. I thought he did a great job all the way around, especially for, like I said, making adjustments and adapting, and, you know, at the last minute. I think he did an amazing job.
Jim!
Yeah!
God,
yeah.
Jim, ninja!
Yes.
Yeah.
Tommy,
meet
the
Molly
crew real quick.
Yeah.
Hello, sir.
Hey,
Tommy.
What's up?
Good to
meet
you,
man. There he is.
Good to
see you again, sir.
Thanks for coming.
Yeah, you guys gonna rock out tonight?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, like,
great,
for sure.
Congratulations, man.
Yeah, congratulations.
Many options out there to do, but also, I feel like I've outgrown this sport a lot. Like, everybody here is new. You know how when they say that's a good basketball team, but they're a young team, and they'll be good in the future, definitely? I feel like that with the whole roster here. All the champions are champions walking with the high horses and stuff. And they're like, not the big league anybody, but they're all rookies to me. So if I leave for a while, then I've got them 4 years in here, and me and the guys to me is out. And even the playing field, I want to fight. I'm not that motivated to fight anybody that's here right now who's not doing major stuff. I feel like I'm about to run this. I'm going to grow bigger than this, and I have bigger goals, higher places.
Well, listen, I want to echo Joe Rogan's sentiments that we will watch wherever you are, Nate. I know that you will conquer whatever you set your mind to. Congratulations on this win, and thank you for always just being so fun to work with, including all week long when there was so much going on. Appreciate it.
Thank you. Don't do not too big, because I'll be right back.
Yes.
Thank you. See you. Clear.
Thanks, guys.
Well, because I started hitting him before he got choked. He wanted it out.
Yeah.
I hit him in the body.
Yeah. Oh, that was good.
I hit him anyway, and I thought, well, and then I hit him again in the body, and he didn't like that at all.
Yeah.
You saw that on Rachel, so I was like,
Ricky, I haven't heard that one. That right at.
Yeah, he was turning, he started running.
Need
he
a
oh, man.
Good shit.
Fuck yeah.
Ready to wrap on it.
Oh,
yeah.
Shit.
Game over.
It is,
Tony.
Yeah. Yeah.
Do you need to see Toby?
That was a really good fight.
I'm the Fabian. I'm Toby and Nick Max from the Fire Sex Perfect.
I need to get some.
You kicked the fuck out of
me.
Best boxing coach out there, man. Doing a big time for everybody. Don't forget. Remember the name, bro. Remember the name.
I'm from Hella Checks. I checked.
No, Hella Checks.
I checked it every time, even when it was big, I would check.
I know.
Even when it was all bust. That's why I kept switching a little, and then I would fake the kick just so it would kill.
That was great. No, that was great. The front kick was on the feint was awesome.
I'm having a sip of this bitch.
All right, we'll see. Well, goddamn.
I'm about to go to the, I think, press somewhere. All right, cool.
Got that doing? Shit down,
like all fucked up.
Yeah, I'm alright. I just
got a big fucking ball on my fucking chin.
Oh, you like that?
No, I love it.
My favorite fucking shoe.
My boy copied me
now. My boy Elijah.
Pleasure. Well, congrats.
good luck with everything, man. And you know, this is always your fucking house if you need anything.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Whatever you need, it's your house, kid.
Love. Let's hang out. Let's hang out. Real soon.
Likewise. Yes, and yeah, have fun at your party tonight.
Yeah, yeah.
Are you going to win?
Yeah, we're going to access.
Perfect.
Hi,
Dana. Nice to meet you.
Let's do a team pick. And later tonight we're doing black belt pick. We got like nine guys here.
Good to see you too.
What's up, Dana?
How are you? Good to see you.
Crazy events.
Congrats, guys.
Thank you.
Have fun tonight, you guys. Good to see you. Oh, I didn't even see you. I'm sorry.
Yeah, no problem, man. Great to see you, boss, as always, man. Great workout.
Come on, boys. All right. I'll see you later. Later.
Oh, yeah. So
congrats.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Right. Your house. Thank you very much.
Good luck with that.
Later, boys.
What's up?
You can keep drinking if you want to.
I just don't
want
to be holding it. You know, there's kids watching. They don't be watching me.
This is your rule, man. You can do whatever you want. Congratulations. Great one.
1, 4, 3. Laura Stanko here for Quick Hits, presented to you by Jose Cuervo Tequila, and I am here with the man, Nate Diaz. And I don't know if you know this yet, but you are now tied with Hoist Gracie for the third most submission wins in UFC history. And that to me, feels like the perfect ending to this insane week, and I know a stressful couple of months for you. Could there be a better ending?
So what are the top two, me and Hoist?
You and Hoist are tied for third place. All-time submission record.
Who's in first and second?
I think we got Oliveira. Man, you're testing
my
memory.
I don't think they counted the Ultimate Fighter one, so I'm still winning.
Targeting the leg quite a bit early in the fight. Did that affect you very much in the third and fourth round as they started to accumulate? I'm gonna have you come up a little bit closer.
I keep backing up
because
you're hella close to the thing, and I'm like,
I know. We gotta stay close, Nate. We gotta stay close. Come on up here.
I'm still in the fight.
Please, dear God, don't punch me. Were the leg kicks affecting you?
I felt like I was blocking the kicks really good. Mm-hmm. And yeah, I'm fucking hurt.
Talk to me about the guillotine.
I blocked him, even the block was hurting. I'm like, I know his leg's hurting right now.
Yeah, when the check hurts, you know it hurts them even more. Yeah. So you pressured him in the fourth round. You pressured him right into a takedown and right into a guillotine. I saw you adjust the grip. Once you adjusted the grip, did you know you'd be able to get that finish?
I could tell when I locked it in that I was going to finish it. And before that, I was hitting the body with punches, and he had to shoot hard. He had to put a real good wrestling shot on because he was taking the hits. So that set up the choke. It's kind of like when I did Connor and Jim Miller and a bunch of other guys. When you start with the punches, they commit to that shot, and that's a finish. So I usually could tell that that's going to be a done deal.
I'm gonna grab you again. Get over here.
Because the mic.
Get over here.
You see what
she's
doing with the mic?
Get over here. I mean, I got.
Let me hold the mic.
All right. You know what? You're the only person I've ever surrendered the mic to. We gotta share. We gotta share that. Okay. So, am I wrong in seeing that you like went over and said something to Tommy Lee in the middle of your fight? Were you talking
to
Tommy Lee?
Yeah, that's what they all told me. But I was just talking to whoever was in front of me, and Tommy Lee was having me there. And that's my partner. We were hanging out last night. That's my boy. So.
Whoa! You were hanging out with Tommy last night before.
Yeah, he was telling me how to whip his ass, and I was like, hell yeah, Tommy. Yeah, because he already knows. He and me. He's like, hey, you guys are the Motley Crue. He didn't say that. I said that. But I was like, hey, hey, Tommy, I brought the Motley Crue to the thing. He's like, I want you to come to the fight, to my concert. It's the night before the fight, but I know you got a fight and you probably got a lot of shit to go. I was like, nah, I'm coming, but I got 20 people with me. He's like, oh damn, but yeah, pull up. So we all went through over there, and he's cool as fuck. And then yeah, he's right there.
So you said hi. What'd you say? Do you remember?
I don't know. They told me I said that something. I was just talking shit. I don't know.
Listen, it was an incredible, incredible finish. You got your sixth career guillotine, and then you went on the mic with Joe, and you said you're gonna go take over another sport. I know you launched Real Fighters Inc. or Real Fight Inc. I should say, this week. I guess what should we look for from you? Where are we gonna see you next?
Well, whatever I do, it's going to be major, and I want to do the biggest thing I could do and fight whoever thinks that, whoever is out there in the world thinking they're the biggest ass whooper and putting on the biggest scenes, then like I said in the past, I beg to differ. I'm going to make that happen with me and them. And then it's going to be co-promoted with Real Fight Inc., which is me. And the sky's the limit, man, and we're taking off.
Yeah. You have always done things the way that you wanted to do them. Mm-hmm. Are you satisfied? Are you happy with how this chapter, not saying it's the last chapter, but how this chapter of your fight career has gone?
Yeah, if you, just think about my career so far, and I think about it like any game. This is the halftime show right now.
I love it. Nate, thank you so much, and congratulations on a phenomenal victory. I feel weird not thanking you. Guys, UFC 280.
Congratulations on your win tonight in your final fight with the UFC performance of the night as well. But did you know the clock stopped at 2:09 of the fourth round?
I saw
pretty
a picture.
Symbolic.
Yeah, cool.
Have you had a chance to really reflect this week, you know, on your career as a whole and the fans and just what all of this means to you?
This has been my whole life, the whole time, you know, and it's been a long road, and I feel like a weight's been lifted off my shoulders, mission complete, objective complete. I'm glad it went the way it did, and I feel like it's just a shit don't ever stop. Step in the next move. Fucked up my leg fighting Tony. I blocked all the kicks. I fucked with him, dude, and my leg blew up like humongous. And I put this fucking ice on my shin because I had a bone mission, and it fucking it dripped down my whole sock and sucked my whole fucking shin.
Dude, Scott.
What the fuck? This is a soaking wet, Travis Scott.
You need some new kicks.
Look at it. Yeah. It should have gave us these to walk out in, huh?
Would you do a shoey in that?
That's gross. Wait all day there and chill and kick in, and then Mark Romandy came out to do a story, and he stayed at the house for a few days. And we were getting smoked all night. He was smoking so much weed. I was like, come on, hit the body. Like, yeah, I'm gonna smoke. And anyway, I'm just playing. He wasn't smoking weed, but I was just trying to make him smoke weed. And,
what the fuck
was
that?
Hey, man. And then, dude, this is a soaking wet Travis Scott. But it was dope. It's dope. Shout out to Inside MMA. I'm sorry I didn't ask the question. I forgot what it was.
Inside Fighting. He always says Inside Fighting. Appreciate it.
Inside Fighting. Shout out to Inside Fighting. I didn't mean to do you like that.
Nate, question.
What was the question now? Did I answer the question?
You got the submission at 2:09. I just want to know what that meant to you. You know, it's pretty cool.
Yeah, that is cool. I didn't know that happened until my boy Chris showed me the picture. It was dope.
What's XS looking like tonight? You know, for the fans watching, like,
we all go to XS. Mark Romani's coming. You guys should all come. We about to get out of here because my shoe's soaking wet, and it was good to see everybody. Thanks for fucking the question. And thanks to all the press for everything. Always love. All right.
Mark the G's out.
I didn't smoke anything.